Are you struggling with your bed leveling on your 3D printer? Want to learn how to adjust your bed leveling screws with and without a probe? You are in the right place. Hi, I am Remy and welcome to my channel. In today's video, I'll be walking you through the process of adjusting bed leveling screws using Clipper firmware. So stick around and let's dive right in. When it comes to bed leveling in Clipper, you have got three solid options. The first is the bed screw method, where you manually adjust the screw using the good old paper test to get your bed perfectly level. The second option is the screw tilt adjust method, which requires a probe like a BL touch, inductive sensor or similar. The third option is bed mesh. The first two methods fall into manual leveling, which I'll be discussing in this video. Both these methods can give you a perfectly level print surface, but they work in different ways. In this video, I'll walk you through both approaches so you can choose what works best for your setup. Keep in mind that these two methods are suitable if your bed is perfectly flat. If not, you might need to replace your bed or opt for a bed mesh option, which I'll explain in my next video. Now let's take a look at how to identify if your bed is perfectly flat. In the following demonstration, I'll be using a simple tool, a straight scale and a source of light. By placing the scale across the bed and flashing a light from behind, we can check for gaps. If you see light passing under the scale, it means the bed is warped or bowed, indicating it's not completely flat. As you can see here, there is light passing under the scale over here and over here. This indicates that this aluminium bed isn't flat and it's bowed in the center. For this, the solution is to have a glass bed. Do not use magnetic build plates for such kind of bed. You'll have the same problem. Now let's see by placing a glass bed surface on top of the aluminium bed. As you can see, there isn't any light passing under the scale. Even in this diagonally placed scale, there isn't any light source which is coming under the scale and over here as well. So for a aluminium bed where the bed isn't flat enough, or if the bed in the center is bowed, you have to have some kind of flat surface on top of it. In my case, I am using this glass bed. As of recording this video, I am using Clipper version 0.12.0. Now let's start with manual leveling of bed. I'll first start with the bed screw method. So under installation and configuration, bed level, manual leveling. And if you scroll down a little, you will find adjusting bed leveling screws. So we need to do this configuration in order for this method to get it working. So let's check this configuration first. Now let's check the requirement for the bed screw to get it working. So if you look over here, it says if a bed screw is under the bed, then specify the XY position directly above the screw. If the screw is outside the bed, then specify the XY position closest to the screw that is still within the range of the bed. If you look here, in my case, I'm using Ender 3. So these knobs or the bed screw are under the bed in these four locations. So for me, I need to put the X and Y coordinate of this particular location. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this X and Y coordination I need to define in the printer.cfg file. Now let's see the configuration. So I have four screws on my bed, as you can see here, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Screw 1 is at position 33 by 201.30. So this would be the rear left corner. The next screw is at this location, front right corner. The third screw is at this location, which is front left corner. And the fourth screw is at this location, which is rear right corner. And the last option over here is speed. This determines the speed at which it will move from one screw to another. And here are the coordinates which I have mentioned in the configuration file. If you notice here, the screw 1 is this location, screw 2 is this location, 3 is over here and 4 is over here. And this is how the print head will move from this location, then here, then over here and here. You can define whichever order you want. I have defined diagonally, so it will start from here, then here and here. Now before we proceed with the test, make sure that the nozzle tip is fairly clean. Next, let's understand turning direction of the knob. As you can see here, I am turning the knob in clockwise direction and the bed is going up. And now counterclockwise and the bed comes down. Now let's see the paper test. Insert a paper between the nozzle tip and the bed and turn the knob as per the desired direction. Turn it, if the gap is more, turn it clockwise so that the gap reduces, or vice versa. What you need to note is the paper should have a slight drag, or you should have slight resistance once you pull the paper. So push the paper back and forth and you should feel the drag. If that is the case, then that's enough. You don't need to be perfect. We can adjust the nozzle height later by doing a test print and adjusting the knob accordingly. Once you have your configuration defined correctly, save it in printed.cfg file. I have a separate file called bedleveling.cfg and this file is included in the printed.cfg file. So here is my configuration. So once you set your configuration, save and restart your printer. Save and restart. Now that we have done the configuration, know how to turn the knob direction and also seen the paper test, let's start with the bed screw method. For that, we need to copy this command. Next, come to your printer interface. Either you are using Fluid or Mainsail. I'm using Mainsail. So this is Mainsail dashboard. Come to the console section over here, or you can also navigate from here, console, over here. It's one and the same. So you can paste the command which you copied and click the play button over here. Or you can click these three dots and select this option, bed screw adjust. It's one and the same. So we'll start with the test. Once you click the play button, you will get a pop-up window. This will go to the screw 1 position. Start the paper test and see, do the paper test and see if there is slight drag for the paper. So the gap between the nozzle and the print bed. So once you are done with the paper test, proceed with the next screw by adjusting. Click on adjust. And then it will move to the screw 2 location. Do the same thing, the paper test. Once you are satisfied enough with the paper drag, click on adjust. It will go to third screw position. Likewise, continue with third screw and the fourth screw by clicking on the adjust button. And once all the 4 screws are adjusted, it will go again in a loop. So do this test continuously until you feel the paper drag or the paper test is consistent among all the 4 screws. So it will keep on going in the circle. So once you are satisfied, click on accept. So now this is the third one. Adjust once the third is the it starts from zero, so this will be the fourth screw. So if you are satisfied, click on adjust, and once this is done, it will go back to the screw 1 position. Do the paper test. If you are satisfied, click on accept. Now it will go to the screw to position. Do the paper test. Satisfied. Or if you have adjusted, click on adjust. And or click on accept if you are satisfied. Likewise, keep the process repeating until all the four screws or all the paper test for the all screws are satisfied and accepted. This loop will keep on continuing. So once all the four screws are, you have accepted the values or the paper test result, you are satisfied and you have clicked on accept for all the four screws, this will keep on continuing. And once you have accepted for all the four screws, this will finish. As you can see, now the pop-up window has closed. Next, we shall see screw tilt adjust method. For this, you need a Z probe such as BL touch, inductive sensor or similar. For this test, the screw one position is the reference point for all the other points. The system assumes that the screw one is at the correct height and must not be changed during the entire calibration. Let's see the available configuration option. Horizontal move Z. The height in mm before starting a probe operation. Default value is 5. So this would be the height of the nozzle from the bed before moving from screw one position to the next position. The speed of a non-probing move during the calibration, that is when moving from screw position 1 to the next position. Default speed is 50. Screw 1. The XY coordinate of the first bed leveling screw. This is a position to command the print head so that the probe is directly above the bed screw or as close as possible while still being above the bed. Keep note, this is the probe location and not the nozzle. This is also the base screw or the reference point used in calculation and must not be changed during the entire calibration. Screw 1 underscore name. An arbitrary name for the given screw. This name is displayed when the helper script runs. Likewise, adjust the name and the XY coordinate for the remaining screws. Screw thread. This is split into two parts. The knob rotation direction CW, that is clockwise, or CCW, that is counterclockwise, and the type of the screw for the bed leveling, such as M3, M4, or M5. Accepted values CW-M3, CCW-M3, CW-M4, CCW-M4, CW-M5, CCW-M5. A clockwise rotation of the knob decreases the gap between the nozzle and the bed, and a counterclockwise rotation increases the gap. My printer is Ender 3 with a clockwise M4 screw. Please note, the knob rotation values to be adjusted during the calibration are displayed in time format, that is R:minutes. A full turn is 1 hour, half turn is 30 minutes, and a quarter turn is 15 minutes. Let's understand by looking at this image. When you turn the knob position from here to here, you'll be turning 15 minutes. Likewise, if you turn the knob position from here and right up to here, that would be 30 minutes. It's a half turn. And so if you turn the knob position from here, you give a full turn back to here, that would be 1 hour, which is a one full turn. This is how we need to interpret the values that will be given us after each calibration test. This is the command for a screw tilt adjust method. Available options are direction, max deviation, horizontal move Z. If direction is specified, the knob turns will all be in the same direction, clockwise or counterclockwise. which means if you set direction as direction equals CW, then the knob direction will always be in clockwise clockwise direction. If max deviation is specified, the command will raise a G-code error if any direction in the screw height relative to the base screw height is greater than the value provided. When we execute this command, we don't need to actually specify all these options, but they are there if you need to try out. I'll be testing by executing only this command. Once you have adjusted your XY coordinates and your configuration is ready, save this configuration in your printer.cfg file and restart. Once you are ready to calibrate, copy this command and navigate to your dashboard. Then go under console, paste the command. But before that, don't forget to home your printer. Once homing is done, you can execute this command. Click on the play button, or you can click on these three dots and click this screw tilt calculate. It's one and the same thing. So I will click this play button over here. Once the calibration is done, you'll be presented with this pop-up window. As you can see here, the first screw, which is rear left screw, is the base one, and this should not be turned, or the knob. Then the front left screw, we need to turn the knob 1 hour 25 minutes. Then the front right, 2 hours 22 minutes, and the last one, 1 hour 22 minutes. As demonstrated earlier, turn the knob accordingly. So this will take one full turn and close to half turn. This one will take two turns and little bit more to a quarter turn. Over here, one full turn and little bit more to a quarter turn. Once that is done, accept the values and repeat the test. Here are a few screenshots of adjusting the knobs after each calibration. And this is the final run. As you can see here, the rear left screw is the base and must not be changed. The goal here is to adjust the remaining screws as close to 0 minute or less than equal to 5 minutes. Now this is the test print done after the first method, which is bed underscore screws. The first layer is very consistent except the front left corner. You might think that there is more gap or the bed is lower in this corner, but it's not. This is the center, front left corner, front right corner, rear right corner, and rear left corner. And this is another test print done after the second test method, which is screws tilt adjust method. The center image, front left, front right, and rear left. And now you all might have a question on how often do we need to do this test. It depends. Printers that have bed that moves back and forth, which are called bed slingers, due to the moving motion, the knobs get loose, and such printers need to adjust the bed more often than that of flying gantry or bed that moves in Z direction. Another one is when we try to remove the print before the bed cools down. Final note, the configuration that I have shown is for my printer setup. Your configuration may vary. Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed this video, please like and share. God bless and keep safe.